Here we have a AC5030, 30-inch Woodsman Buzzsaw, a cordwood saw. As you can see, the PTO is already engaged, just to save a little bit of time here. And I'm using this saw to trim some splits that are too long for my wood stove. You can see a few right there, most of them, it's like, you know, even as much as a half an inch can keep the door from closing on my tiny stove. But most of them are, say, 1 to 2 inches too long. Should have been 16, but or 18 instead. You know how it is. Anyways, I have a small pile today that I'm going to do for a demo. But I actually have probably 200 or more that need to be trimmed down. And it's a great way to use this tool. Also, you know, obviously its original purpose was to take small limbs and easily process them down to whatever size you wanted them. You know, bring them up to the table in 4, 6, or 8 foot lengths. You know, whatever. It depends really on how heavy they are and unwieldy. Place them on the table and just simply, you know, push a table in, cut off a piece, slide it up forward, another piece, slide it forward, etc., etc. Makes quick work of small stock. This firewood is a couple of years or a year and a half dry, so I'm not going to jam it right through. It'll cut faster through wet food. Through wet wood. And I've already inspected the wood for nails and hardware. That's definitely something you want to do before using this. Definitely do not want to be putting metal into this implement. And of course, safety glasses and muffs. Beyond that, loose fitting clothing is a no-no. And my preference is to not wear gloves should something unfortunate happen. I'd rather have it, you know, take a fingertip off than have it pull me into the saw by grabbing leather or fabric and making a bad situation even worse. And you'll notice that I like to push the table more with my leg or my body while keeping control of the wood with my hands. But certainly you could just push the table with arm power if you want. I just find it a little bit easier to moderate the speed using my body. Anyway, so I'm going to rev her up, and here we go. That's it. It's about 9 minutes. A lot of gabbing on there. So it makes quick work of that wood. And, you know, obviously more horsepower tractor. You know, this one's probably about 23-ish at the PTO. Around 30 at the in the engine. You know, plenty of power to run this thing. And green wood, it just cruises right through that. But this stuff is pretty dry. So anyways, thanks for watching.